Word, glory to God. And it works. word is his will. Say with me, I got angels on assignment.
I got angels on assignment.
And I got help.
And I got help.
To meet the needs that God has already promised me. See, you need to know the whole truth and nothing but the truth. And so this morning we're continuing in this URAP teaching series as always. I think as long as Wholeness Environment Ministry is in the earth, the URAP teaching series is a perpetual thing. Why? Because we must always understand. See, people say the Bible, but God makes things simple. He makes it so simple. Everybody know what it means to understand something, right? You know what it means to receive. You know what it means to activate. I got to get up from where I am. And I got to go take what God said in mind by force. Why? Because I got a devil that is loose. I got an enemy on assignment, glory to God, that comes to hinder me, that comes to shipwreck the greatest thing that God has given me. The greatest thing that God has given you as a child of God is a mustard seed of faith. Say with me, I got to add to my mustard seed. I got to be a wise farmer. See, a wise farmer.
Jesus.
Say with me, a wise farmer,
a wise farmer
knows how to collect,
on
his harvest.
That's right.
And that's me.
And that's me.
I understand.
What I sow
is what I reap.
I sow in faith.
I sow in believing God.
I sow in
understanding.
I
understand what God has for me. So I sow in activating it.
I sow
in worship.
I sow in
praise. I sow in my words. Therefore, I got to be careful what I say. My words is a seed. I sow in my thoughts what I think. Because the Bible say, as I think, so I get. And so I got to allow my thinking to line up with God's thinking. God said, more than a conqueror. I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Pain shall not prosper. Lack shall not prosper. Hatred shall not prosper. Anger shall not prosper. Murder shall not prosper. Jealousy shall not prosper. Gossip shall not prosper. I am the fighter. Today.
That's right.
And you got to be willing to rise up and get angry and declare, I got angels on assignment. And so you know that if you got angels on assignment, you got what you need. Say with me, this is part three. But I need to tune back into one or two in the archive so I can get this full message that's coming full circle to my understanding. See, when the lights come on, this place is very dark. There are no windows in this building. And so when we turn off all the lights, you can't see. But when the understanding of God illuminates your spirit, man, you say, wow. Your soul, your spirit, the real you becomes unstoppable. See, it is your soul, the Bible says, be renewed. Be transformed by your soul, because your spirit is already alive and ready to meet the requirement of God. But it is your soul that's hindering me. Say, no longer my soul gonna hinder me. I'm gonna walk in the spirit because my soul is ready to do this. And so we're continuing in this manner of God. This is the year of the miraculous of God. And God is working miracles and signs and wonder in this season. But he is doing it only to those who are knowledgeable as to what God is doing. And see, when the strong, when the knowledgeable have enough in them, you can cause the ignorant, those that are unchurched and unlearned, right, to receive the umbrella of the same miracle.
Right.
God working you, that's what Paul did.
Right.
The Bible speaks of the handkerchiefs and all these things that came from his clothing that overshadowed the people and called them the records of God to be made known. Amen. Say with me, I'm working on something. I'm giving up my nothing. The stuff that ain't working for me. And I want everything God has for me. So in our last teaching, I got angels on assignment. Glory to God. And we know we're going to the book of Hebrews. Go ahead and turn to that book. Hebrews, the first chapter. Glory to God. Welcome, glory to God. Hallelujah. Through more folks in the house to be full. Glory to God. Welcome to Wholeness and Power Ministry. Amen. Hallelujah. I see this place full. I really do. I see it busting loose. Glory to God. This is just one of our locations. Amen. In our last teaching concerning the angels on assignment, we say that angels are sent by God. And they are sent for his purpose. And they are sent for his people. The Bible says heaven is a prepared place for a prepared people. We said that the angels were sent to care for those who are what? Of salvation. That means they are plugged in with God. They are connected. And so as we get into this wonderful teaching today, I hope I don't swing across that chandelier doing a cartwheel, because this is a powerful word. And this word is causing me to be catapulted into a crazy dimension. One day I'm going to tell y'all my full testimony, glory to God. One day, glory to God, when God released me to tell you everything. And so we know that the angels, they are equipped by God with the capacity to move like the wind. We know that the effects of angels work because of God's presence is upon them. And so we know that the Bible says where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. That means liberty to prosper, to be in good health, even as your soul prospers. Knowledge is there, increase is there. There's no hidden thing. You're not in the dark. You're not in the dark with yourself. Why? Because when the Spirit of the Lord is there, when the angels, when the wind of the Spirit is upon you, he will speak to you and he'll tell you what's going on in you. He'll tell you what's going on with the people around you, glory to God. He'll tell you what's going on in the neighborhood. He'll warn you before catastrophe falls. Many people are alive today because God said, don't go to work today. They stay home and they're alive. Uh-huh. Many people didn't go into the Twin Tower. Uh-huh. Because God, for whatever reason, told them to do whatever. Uh-huh. And they listened. Many people died that God told them to stay home. I bet you that. They were supposed to be somewhere else. But because they didn't hear the voice of God, they ended up in a place where they weren't safe. So we're going to talk about the safety place. So we're still recapping. So we know that we define the term angel in its Hebrew. Angel, Hebrew is what we were singing this morning. When we say, well, who are saved? Worthy is the Lamb. You know, when we say, Elohim, Moshe Kol Yokol, hallelujah, worthy, holy. These are all Hebrew words. Hebrew is God's language. It is the original language of God. It is what the Bible was written in, the Old Testament. And so we looked at the term angel. We saw it in its Hebrew term of malak, M-A, we said L apostrophe A-K. And we saw it in its Greek term, angelos, with angel with O-S on the end, both meaning divine messenger. And so this messenger, we said, can be of human kind. But the focus on this teaching, we're talking about the angelic, the divine angels of the Lord. We're not talking about the angel. I'm styled as an angel. You're styled as an angel. When you carry God's message in your belly, in your womb, and you got something to say, glory to God. But we're talking about the angelic angels, glory to God. Well, you asked me about that. So we say that angels move by the authority of God. And we talked about the authority. We teached on that 2 weeks ago, one Friday night. The authority of God in its Greek term means exousios. When you hear somebody say exousios, one thing about them, you should be well educated.
Right.
Exousios means the authority of God. You walk in the exousia, which means the power of God. Why? Because God has given you what you need. He's given you the requirements to walk in it. He didn't tell you, you know, it's like you go on a job and they hire you and they tell you to go do something but don't give you the tools to do it. And you look at them and you say, huh? I want you to type this letter, but they don't give you a computer. You want me to type this letter? What do you mean? And so they say, you figured it out. But God did not leave you hanging. He has given you power, glory to God. And so this authority is not by our will. This authority of the angel is not by what we want them to do. It is not even, except it's in the word of God. We know that. We know we got to stick closely to what the word says. It's not even by their own will. It is by, or the will of men. But it is by the Spirit of God. We say that they are also interpreters. They interpret what God is saying to you. You may have a dream, and an angel may become, it may be a physical angel that you can see like flesh and blood, but it's not flesh and blood. The Bible says, be careful how you entertain strangers. Some people have entertained angels unaware, or it may be by a real angel. They are also mediators. They stand between God and man. And we're going to see that. I believe we're going to get to that today. We saw one area of them being a mediator and interpreter, glory to God, in the word of God. And so we'll even see more of that as we go along. So they're also called harvesters of God. They gather. They're going to be the one that gather the saints out of the four winds of the earth. The scriptures say that God sends his angels like the wind. We define the Hebrew term for the word wind. We say wind means ruah, which means in relation to God, spirit. It means spirits or breath. Ruah in relation to angels and humans. Why? We have a ruah. You have a spirit. The real you is spirit. Glory to God. So, glory to God. We saw in our Monday night Bible study, we talked about the wind. We talked about the east wind. It's so magnificent how God tied in Monday night. It was Sunday. I don't know how. You think I play? You think I'm smart enough to put all this together? Am I prophetess? She know me very well. I'm really not. Glory to God. I'm not that smart to put this together. But it happened simultaneously, time after time. So Monday night, we were talking about the wind, the east wind of God, glory to God, and how this, the east wind, is God's vehicle. Even Christ will be coming out of the east. When we see him, the Bible says the light will flash out of the east to the west. And even Christ, when Christ comes, Christ is coming with two people. He's coming with the saints, us, and he's coming with the angels out of the east in the air. Glory to God. I believe that you're going to be riding on your own spiritual horse, or however God do it, coming out of the east with Christ. And so we saw the wind, the ruah, in relation to these three. Glory to God. And we are spirit, as I say, we are the breath of God. So you have the power to speak. Allow your breath, your spirit, your ruah, to speak what you want to see. Glory be to God. Why? Because God has enabled you. The Bible says death and life is in the power of your tongue. Say with me, I got what I say. Keep on saying, I got more than enough. When you see life, I got more than enough. I got more than enough. My body is healed. God is working for me. He's working in ways I don't even understand. You got to allow yourself to come up to this word and praise God no matter what. This is not crazy, but this is real. This is why God. You got to stay connected to the body of Christ. You got to surround yourself with the right people.
That's
people
right.
that are going to encourage you
That's
and
me.
Lift you up into the faith of God and cause you to reach your destiny in God. Hallelujah. My God, say with me, God has called me to greatness. Glory to God. I will leave a legacy in this earth. You got to say, I'm going to leave a legacy for my children. I'm going to leave a legacy for my neighbor. I'm going to do something different. You got to dare to speak that over your own life. Glory to God. And so we saw Israel and the prophet Ezekiel challenged by the wind. Glory to God. Breath to call for life. And so when we speak, we call it according to God's word and not our own. We went in Psalms 103rd chapter in the 20th verse. And we saw where the Bible say, people say, I hear people say, you can't command angels. This is one of the things that we highlighted. One of the things we highlighted. But Psalms 103, we said, angels listen, the Bible says, to God. And they do according to what? Your voice? His word. When your voice speak his word, he wants the best for you. My God say, I am healed. My God say, I have what I need. My God say, I'm more than a conqueror. So when your words speak what God's words say, I can do great exploits. Glory to God. There are great exploits in my belly. I am a creator. Just like my father spoke and it was, so shall I speak and it will. And it will be. You know who come, go and make what you say come alive? The angels.
The
east wind of God. The power of God. Glory to God. And they move according to God's word. So we saw that. And we saw for 1 John 5:14 say, if we act according to God's what word, he what hears us. And if we know, you see your faith, you got to partner with God the right way. You know how you take a test? You got to answer the question right to get 100. You go in there and answer the question. You don't study for. They done gave you all the curriculum. What it need, what you need to do to get your license. But you work the thing according to your way. And you don't work it according to state board. So all the questions you answer there, you answer them according to what you. You know how we do things. We do things in the way we want. Say you a hairdresser. And you say, no, we just click it and do it like that. You know, we just take the comb and we pick it up off the floor. We just blow it. And it's clean. And on state board, it tells you you need to dip that comb in some chemicals and clean it right. So you got to answer the test right in order to get your license. So in order to get the benefit of what God says concerning you, you got to be able to answer this test, this testing of this trying of your faith with the right answer. Meaning I got to plug my faith in. I got to plug my obedience in. I got to plug holy unto the Lord. Stamped on my heart. Permeating in my very being that I am the temple of God and I am called to prosper. You got to do this thing according to his way. He said, those that love me, I love them. Those that are faithful to me, I will be faithful to you. Read the book. He promised you this. And so this morning we're continuing in this teaching where as we stop off at go to the book of Hebrews. In our last teaching, we were speaking about the angels being servants, flames of fire.
Right.
And we'll refresh ourselves in this passage. I'll read Hebrews starting at the 5th verse, 1st chapter. For God never said, and we know that the Son, Jesus, is greater than the angels. We don't worship angels. We know that. We only worship Christ. When John on the Isle of Patmos began to fall before the angels say, get up from him.
That's right.
Worship the Lord only. We don't worship angels. We don't call them and say, come angels, I worship you angels. You don't worship angels.
That's right.
That's sort of like want to seek God's hand and not his face.
That's right.
I want the protection. I want the care, but I don't want to love you.
Okay.
What kind of relationship is that? Spouses want whatever they can get. I want what makes me feel good. I don't really want to be honorable to you. I don't want integrity. I just want what I can get. You say with me, I don't want that.
I don't want that.
Anybody want that? So neither do your father. Say with me, my father cares for me. He loves me. And I love him. He takes well care of me. Every day is Father's Day. Every day I wake up is my God's day. Every day. So let's read this scripture. Fifth verse. But God never said to his angel what he said to Jesus. You are my son. Today I become your father. God also said, I will be his father and he will be my son. He's talking about Jesus. And when he brought his supreme son into the world, he said, let all of God's angel worship who? Him. Jesus, the son. Regarding the angels, he said, his angels like the winds, his servants like flames of fire. But to the Son, he said, your throne, O God, endureth forever and ever. You rule with a scepter, which meaning a staff, a rod of justice. You love justice and hate evil. So if God hate evil, he loves justice. Say with me, I got to be holy. I can't live in evil and expect God to bless me. I must be holy. Holiness without, the Bible say, no man shall see the Lord. So I don't want God hating on me because I choose to walk in evil. I got to choose holiness to the Lord. And I can only do that by his spirit. Amen. Therefore, oh God, I'm still in the ninth verse. Your God has anointed you, pouring out the oil of joy on you more than on anyone else. Come on, God. You receive that. He has anointed you. You shall always be joyous. The joy of the Lord is your strength. You lose that, you got nothing. You give up everything.
Right.
You got to let God's word mirror your vision and your expectation and what you're looking forward to.
Right.
Let me tell you something. There are some things in this world that will water you down. The devil is walking up and down seeking to destroy you. He wants to strip you from joy. He wants you to always be sad and looking ugly. Your joy ain't in no man. It's not in a woman. It's not in your children. It's not in money. It's not in housing and cars. It's not in food. It's not in ministry. It is in the Lord. Your personal relationship. Your relationship knowing that he has a place prepared for you and you belong to him. That's where your joy is. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 10th verse say, he also says to the Son, in the beginning, Lord, you laid the foundation of the earth and made the heavens with your hand. They will perish, but you remain forever. Who wants to be with something that don't remain forever? But the one that remains forever, that's who I want more than anything. And nobody wants him to be forgetting that. Tell yourself that. They will wear out like old clothes, glory to God, the foundation of the earth and people. But you will fold them up like a cloak and discard them like old clothing. But you are always the same. You will live forever. And God never said to any of his angels, we're talking about you got angels on the side of it, but put angels in their right place. We're not putting them on a pedestal. We're not worshiping them. They made a mistake. They sinned just like we did. They fell from grace just like we do. So we're not worshiping them. But he never said to his angels, sit in the place of honor at my right hand until I humble your enemies, making them a footstool under your feet. Therefore, angels are only servants, spirits, sent to care for people who will inherit salvation. And so angels are readily available at all times, 24/7. Some of you are alive. I believe I'm alive today because of an angel. Some of you are still alive today because of God's angel of protection. And they are sent to care for those who are children of the living God, the Most High God. And so they are wind of the Spirit, serving with the flames of fire. So they are serving in God's passion. They are passionately serving God's benefit, that benefit which concerns you. See, we think that sometimes we look at God, you just worried, you just want to, I know you own everything, but you just looking out for yourself. You're not looking out for me. God said, I am looking out for you, but you're not receiving what I have for you. I want you to come to me the right way. If I bless you in your wickedness, in your sin, you'll feel that, you know, I'm all right. God's still blessing me. I know I'm lying, cheating, ducking and diving, shucking and jiving, and God's still blessing me. He will not bless you when you're living in sin. He will not bless you when you're living holy. Catch what I'm saying? What I am saying, there's a moment that you must be tested. God will go mute on you when you're doing all that you know to do with God. And he'll act like he don't even know you.
Amen.
If he did it to Jesus, he'll do it to you. Why did Jesus have to go to people spitting on him and whipping him and talking all kind of junk to him? Then nail him to a cold, lonely cross. Why would God allow himself to be nailed to a cross? The reason he allowed you to go through and be nailed to a cross and he goes silent on you, he's killing you daily. He's killing your faith, your flesh, to allow your faith to rise. You got to know that God is God even when he's not moving for you.
Amen.
You say.
Yes.
I'm going to tell you this. He is moving. He is. See, with this thing, it doesn't matter what you see with these eyes. Because these eyes will fool you.
Amen.
See, we are people are full of, and we were born in sin, the Bible said. And that spirit of hypocrisy is on the man. It is on our nature. We know how to do things just for ourselves. You know, I'm just going to do a little. I'm going to manipulate the situation just till I get what I want. People use people to get what they want and then they go. You think God will allow you to use him for what you want, then you take that body, that temple, that holy body he give you to just do what you want to do? God say, I got work for you to do. And I want to do what I want you to do, not what you want to do. If my son could be in the garden and say, not my will, but your will be done, that's what I want for you.
Amen.
See, your will would be, Lord, I want it now. Give it to me now. God say, no. Say with me, teach me the way, Lord.
Teach me the way
to praise. Teach me the way to
thanksgiving.
I'm going to tell you how to get it from God quickly. By understanding this quickly. When you understand this quickly, you tell on yourself. You know you tell on yourself too? God. Read the Psalms. Read Proverbs. David cried out to God. The moment you were trying, you think you could fool God, you're done. You're done. Nobody can help you. Just because I see, I don't see it, don't mean nothing.
Yeah.
It means nothing what I see.
Amen.
I'm flesh just like you.
Amen.
I'm just a cup.
Yes.
But when you are ready to let God do it for you, you know what your issues are. You will get before him and you will say, God,
yes.
I know this was wrong. God said, I know. Come on, baby. I'm ready for you. And I'm going to cover you with my love under my faint wings, under my feathers. We're going to get this in the word. So this is the passion of God. The angels serve in. This is what serving in God's righteous cause. Not our cause in the way we see it. They're serving according to what God wants. Glory to God. What God wants is what godliness that he wants. Dignity. So the angels serve according to godliness and dignity. See, flames of fire is just another manifold, which means it's another way of God moving. It's just another manifestation of his presence. He's passionate. You get passionate about things. And when your character, people can tell, oh, she's feeling good today. That's her posture. I can tell when you're happy and I can tell when you're sad. Your posture. So these flames of fire are resting upon the angels of the Lord, glory to God, resembling his passion for us, meaning he's readily willing to do it. His flame. flames of fire resembles his anger against sin. His flames of fire resembles his wrath against the devil. His judgment. His righteous indignation. Glory to God. See, any means that come up against you, God's anger are passionately right now ready. His fire is passionately ready to burn up that addiction you got. Whatever it takes to put you on the refiner's fire, he will put you there and burn up everything that's not like him. And he'll use the angel to light the torch. God says, stick it to him. Burn it up. And that's what you want. You want to be purified. You want to be holy. You want to be cleansed. That's why we have our prayer open in the 6 a.m. prayer open in the noonday. That's why we have our Saturday morning soaking, coming before the altar, laying before the Father. You need this. Because there's so much going on at home that we got to fight like hell to pray. So when you jumpstart yourself in the companies of the saints, you take what you get in the house of the Lord, where your strength is. The Bible says, forsake not the assembling of yourself. What you get here, then you take it home. Then you cause your home to be purified. Them demons can't walk around your home.
Amen.
And they can't stay in your children.
Amen.
Why? Because you make your home a haven for God.
Lord
God. And so his passion with fierce fire is ready to eradicate sin. My God. Glory to God. So when we cast all our cares upon him. See, your cares you cast upon the Lord is not the Lord, I need some money. I need healing. No, this the care God wants you to cast on him also. God, I need the deliverance.
That's right.
Deliver me from lying, God. This care is just really, really rotting my bone. Deliver me, Lord, from hypocrisy. Deliver me from adultery and fornication. Deliver me from jealousy. Deliver me from hate. Deliver me from murder. Deliver me from strife. This is the care, and this is ruining me, God. He said, cast it upon him. Why? Because his angel's going to take care of
him. That's right.
They're going to put a torch to it, as I say. So we serve a God that never sleep or slumber. He never wink or whimper. He's never afraid, glory to God. He is always readily available for you. He is working on your behalf, and the heavenly angels are moving. Go with me, Genesis, the 16th chapter. The heavenly angels are moving like the wind among the cabins of the earth, glory to God. Although we can't see them face there, they are at work. Why? Because this is what Hebrews says. That these angels, according to Hebrews 1:14, a ministering spirit, sent forth to care for me. I am one of God's inheritance of salvation. You need to get in. If you get in on Monday night, if you don't go back and archive and whet your appetite about this river, glory to God, this water of life, about the new Jerusalem, the new earth and the new heaven is going to be right here in the earth. My God, your hope, that's why your hope is depleted. You got to expect something great. It's like planning a wedding. It's like I'm getting ready for this grand feast. I am so I can't even stand it.
Jesus.
One day, I'm going to tell you my testimony.
Jesus.
So he's a God that never sleep or slumber. He is working. Angels bring us messages of God's deliverance. We're going to the 6th verse. They bring the word of the Lord. They bring truth concerning God's heart for you. His very instructions. You got to be ready to hear the angels, hear the voice of God speaking, and be ready to do it. Be ready to submit to God. Say with me, I'm ready to submit to God.
I'm ready to submit to God.
But I'm going to tell you this, angel of ministers of the gospel, like me, I'm your pastor. When I counsel you, when I tell you to do something, and you don't do it, that's like you're telling God I ain't doing that.
That's right.
Really?
That's the truth.
Mm-hmm. So if you don't follow God's instruction, you don't get what God has for you.
That's right.
Basically, you abort it.
Right.
You basically shut it down. Mm. Glory to God. Go with me to the 6th verse. I want to make sure you get this word. Say with me, God, I'm open to hear. I call your ears open, your spirit open, your eyes open, your understanding open, your hope open, your expectation open, your strength open, your joy open. Everything God has for you, open your mind, open to this word. Sixth verse. Adam replied, look, she is your servant, so deal with her as you see fit. Listen to the word. Then Sarah treated Hagar so harshly that she finally ran away. The angel of the Lord found Hagar beside a spring of water in the wilderness along the road to Shur. The angel said to her, Hagar, Sarah's servant, where have you come from and where are you going? I'm running away from my mistress, Sarah, she replied. But the angel of the Lord said to her, return to your mistress and submit to her authority. Then he added, I will give you more descendants than you can count, to name him Ishmael, which means God hears. Say with me, God hears. He is Jehovah Roah, the Lord that hears and sees. For the Lord has heard your cry of distress. Can you see yourself in Hagar? This son of yours will be a wild man, as untamed as a wild donkey. He will raise his fist against everyone, and everyone will be against him. Yes, he will live in open hostility against all his relatives. And so we see the angel of the Lord working in the prophetic, glory to God, moving in the prophetic of God, giving instruction, foretelling what God is doing. And so we see how this angel speaks. The way he's speaking, though, it is on condition. Say with me, the word of God is on condition.
The word of God is on condition.
This is the story of God promising Abram to be the father of many nation. Do you understand? If you are Abraham's seed, that same blessing is upon you. You are blessed and enabled by your inherent ability as a son of God to produce nations in your belly. So God had released a blessing upon them, but yet they were old, y'all, dried up. You may be old, you may be dried up, you may consider yourself unlearned and not able to really crack some things. You may see yourself as broken and bruised and old and aged, or just too young for God to use somebody like you. But God has already released that same word he released upon Abraham over you. So in all that, Sarah, in the wisdom of her own self, rose up in her own mind, I'ma help God. Say with me, if I'ma help God out, I got to be willing to suffer the conditions. It came back on it really deep, emotionally. Glory to God. And so in all that, this is, I wanted, some of you didn't understand the story, to come up to what we were reading so you won't be out there. And so Sarah said, I'm going to help God out. And she called this woman Hagar, which was a handmaiden. Come here, Hagar. I can't have no children. And God said, my husband is going to be the father of many nations. So I need, since I'm barren, I can't have no children. I'm old and dried up. You go have children for me. But yet God was planning for her. And he had already told her, you're going to produce and bring forth. So she allowed her handmaid to go and have a child for her. And now Sarah rose up in envy. She rose up in jealousy. She rose up in strife. And so she told Abraham, this bond woman son, Hagar, is not going to get what my son going to get. Get rid of her. And so that's what she had to leave. Abraham had to go to her and tell her, you got to leave. So they found, the angel of the Lord found her in the wilderness, in a place of distress. And so we are there today as a church of the living God, because we've done things our own way. We haven't sought God's face. Like he said, seek my face and then you shall find me. Call upon me in the day of your trouble, then I will answer you. If you will come close to me, then I will come close to you. So if we don't follow God's instruction, we allow the enemy and everything around us to use us for their own benefit.
My God.
Sarah, you take out for her own benefit.
Yes,
how many want to be used? You want men using you? You want women using you? You want the devil using you? You want yourself using you? You got to rise up and say, no, I want God to use me. So the angel of the Lord met up with her to encourage her, glory to God. And so sometimes we are in at the mercy of God. We are in at the mercy of men. And that's where she is. And men will use us like cattle. But yet God, glory to God, knows how to come and rescue his children, glory to God. He knows when you have been mistreated. Some of you have been mistreated unfairly on your job. God, see, he knows. He's delivering you even now. You just got to stay in that character of God. God will send the angel of the Lord to strip and bring you out. Why? Because sometimes fear will cause us to stay there. And let the enemy use us like cattle. And God, that is not God's will. But he will send an angel with the favor of the Lord resting upon him. The angel of favor will call somebody to favor you and see you working hard. If that happens to the world, can it happen to you? Say it with me, that can happen to me. My husband know what favor is. Glory to God. God given us favor.
Amen.
He has given us favor, so much favor that I can't even explain it.
Amen. Glory. Thank you.
Glory to God.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. I'm going to say this. My nephew had to know what favor is.
Amen.
When people fire you off a job, and it's your fault, somebody already done saw you and told you they want to hire you. And they're going to pay you better than you were getting paid. You tell me that ain't favor.
That's right.
You tell me that ain't the prayers of the saints.
That's right.
That's favor. Because the enemy want to ruin him and take it back where he once was. But every time I see him, I'm impressed. I haven't seen him high in a long time. Unless he's holding it real good. He's doing real well. Because we're praying for him. He's one that we're praying for.
Amen.
Amen. So God is working. Say with me, God is working for me.
God is working for me.
I'm going to listen to the angels.
And
what they tell me to do. So you got to be encouraged and know that God sees and he knows. And so you can't allow your emotion to shipwreck your faith.
Oh, that's it.
Because she could have sucked them. His messenger is, they come to what? Bring us what we need. In our time or what? His time.
His time.
And so angels work or operate within God's authority that come from God. They have no response or option to bargain with you. It was the angel that went and released Lot and his family from destruction.
Right.
Sodom and Gomorrah, I'm getting ready. The angel said, we're going to get ready to destroy this place in 3 days. Are you coming
right.
with me?
Right.
Are you coming with me? I'm coming to save you. Glory to God.
Wow.
I'm coming to save you. Sometimes God will have me to save people spiritually. And I tell them God is calling you up higher.
Come on.
Remember one young lady some years ago? I snatched her from where she was. Mm-hmm. Where she ran.
Mm-hmm.
God is calling you up higher. Been trapped for years, but God is calling you up higher. She came. But yet she went up.
Jesus.
When God is calling you higher, you got to be in position to get what God has for you.
That's right. That's key. You got to be in position.
Wow.
My God.
Say with me, she might be my mama, but I ain't following her.
No. No.
No, say that. She might be my mama. I'm going to tell you why I say that. Say what, man? She might be my mama.
She might be my mama.
But I ain't following her. I'm speaking for Lot's children.
Amen.
Did you catch it?
Yeah. Oh, my God.
If Lot children going to say, oh, my mama, my mama.
Jesus.
The children follow the instructions of the Lord. The angel of the Lord say, run and don't look back. Some of you are running to bad habits. You're running to miserable people, miserable situations, miserable neighborhood, on a miserable job. And God say, run. Many are sitting under a miserable congregation with a miserable head that they know they ain't saved, and they stay right there.
Jesus.
There are imposters everywhere you go. And if you listen to God's voice, He will lead you the right way. The angels will never draw you into men or themselves. The angel of the Lord draws you into the Lord's protection. They draw you into what God has for you. You have angels on assignment 24/7. Say with me, I have angels on assignment 24/7. They're working for me. I'm not afraid of I-95. I'm not afraid to fly. I'm not afraid of a ship. I'm not afraid to swim. I'm not afraid to go on the train. I'm not afraid to cross the highway. I'm not afraid to walk across the brook. I got angels on assignment. And if God needs me there, He can keep me. He is well able. Psalms 91. My God, hallelujah. You got to know that I got angels on assignment and they are working for me. Glory to God. When you dare to believe this word, glory to God, you must continue to speak this word over your entire life. I feel Jesus in the place. You don't have to be afraid. You don't have to be scared of the terror by flight. Let's get in the word. Let's go to Psalms 91. The word covers your very thoughts. Glory to God. Your own soul can't turn up against you in times of test. Meaning your soul will come to you scared, you fearful, you say, hell no, I ain't. You're a liar, devil. Yeah. We was in praise and worship, and I began to shout and dance because my mind went back to Revelation, the 22nd chapter. I went to thinking about that river. And that devil tried to say, well, what if that's not real? I said, you are a liar. It's real and it's for me and it's waiting for me. And I'm waiting for it. I'm partaking in that river right now, devil. If I could partake it in the joy of the Lord, the fruit of love and peace flowing out of my belly, who wouldn't want to be ready for a literal a river that I can walk in? That I can stand up in and fish. You got to come on Monday night. So this word covers you. Glory to God. But you got to speak and operate not in your understanding, but in His understanding. I speak an understanding heart over your heart. An understanding soul. Glory to God. A soul that's readily ready to receive God. Psalms 91. I'm going to read this entire passage and then we're going to talk about it. It reads in the New Living Translation, Psalms 91. Glory to God. Those who live in the shelter of the Most High will find rest in the shadow of the Almighty. This I declare about the Lord. He alone is my refuge, which is my protection, my place of safety. He is my God. I trust Him, for He will rescue you from every trap. He's talking about about you. Say with me, God is talking about me.
God is talking about me.
He will rescue you from every trap and protect you from deadly disease. He will cover you with his feather. He will shelter you with his wings. His faithful promises are your armor and protection. Do not be afraid of the terrors of the night, nor the arrow that flies in the day. Do not dread the disease that stalks in darkness, nor the disaster that strikes at midnight. Though 1,000 fall at your side, though 10,000 are dying around you, these evils will not touch you. Just open your eyes and see the wicked are punished. If you make the Lord, if you make the Lord, if you make the Lord your refuge, if you make the Lord your, the Most High, your shelter, no evil will conquer you. No plague will come nigh your home, for he... This is where we're getting. This is our main throb. This is our main focus, because you're ready to do all that the Bible is telling you to do. You're ready to do your part. Say, I'm ready. I am doing my part. 11 verse 8, for he will order his angels to protect you wherever you go. They will hold you up with their hand so you won't even hurt your foot on a stone. You will trample upon lions and cobras. You will crush fierce lions and serpents under your feet. The Lord say, I will rescue those who love me. See what I said? Those who love me, I love them. I will rescue those who love me. Say with me, I love God. My love is foolproof. Because I obey him. I will protect those who would trust in my name. You see the conditions? This scripture, this passage, this chapter, full of conditions. When they call on me, I will answer. I will be with them, what? In trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. I will reward them with a long life. I will give them my salvation. And so Hagar called upon the Lord. And she was readily open and ready to obey the voice of God. God's word is speaking, glory to God. But he is giving his angels direction. He's giving them direction. And he's giving you direction. Are you listening to what God is saying that you must do? Say with me, I'm ready to be available. I'm ready to obey him no matter what. What source he uses to lead.
Oh, my God.
If he can use a donkey, a mere ass, they call him, surely he can use somebody to lead me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Say with me, I have angels on the side of me. God is rescuing me now.
God is rescuing me now.
God is rescuing me now. Today. Because I got ears and hear. I'm listening. And so to those who are listening and open, God's protection is ready. To those who what? Live under this shelter of God. See, when you obey God, you can only obey God when you're under the shelter. Oh, disobedient people can't come under this shelter. People that insist on being a mere man. See, you got to relinquish. You got to give up your opinion. Give up your emotion. Give up the point that the fact that I was hurt and I ain't forgiving nobody. You got to give that up. You got to be with it. For God, I live and God, I die. If God forgave me, truly I can forgive them. Truly I can work this day according to God's will. Who are abide under this shelter. To live means to abide. It means to reside. It means you stay, glory to God. Meaning you do not have the privilege of coming in and out like you want.
My God.
slave that's under the house and under the authority of master. Slaving of the old patriarch in the days of old was ordered by God. God allowed it to be so us can get this. If God allowed it to be, it was in his order. Slaves don't go in and out of the mess. How long I'm going out in the night mess. Oh. I ain't asking mess a word. I'm going, girl. You going with me? Wait the mess to catch up with you. But God is not like the worldly master. He isn't. He allows you to be a slave with a will. Say with me, I'm a slave with a will.
Amen.
You don't believe you're a slave? Look at the word. So those who stay under the covering, under the shelter, you can't go in and out of the things of God. Don't believe people will say, I'm going to drop down my religion, cuss you out for a minute. You know, you wait till I'm gonna shake this weave off, I'm gonna snatch this weave off, and I'm gonna really get down with it. You finna see the real side of me. You supposed to be a minister of the gospel. You got people that call themselves Christians,
wow,
ministers, and they act like that. Seriously.
Like that.
They go, they act like the world. Oh, I'm out now. Full of lust. Oh, I'm out, I got, I'm letting my hair down tonight. Adam, where are you? You're supposed to be always covered. I am under his shelter, meaning I'm abiding in him, meaning I'm abiding in holiness everywhere I go. I do not have the opinion to say I'm not going to be holy today. I was holy Sunday. See, your pastor would never trick you, and you're wondering why things ain't working for you. You got to stay holy under this protection, under this covering. Jesus said, those who abide in me, those that abide in him, and they and is they who abide in the word. Abide means to live. And you know what the benefit of that? He said, you ask what you want and I'll give you.
Bring it right to you.
And so we find rest in God. Therefore, fear, worry, doubt, has no more dominion over us. Read Matthew the 6th chapter where it talks about worry about nothing. If God takes care of the lily of the field and the birds of the air, surely, say with me, surely, God will take care of me. Glory to God. So we become stable in God. Why? Because we're under him. Because we now have his protection. His angels are protecting us. And they are holding us up. Why? So we won't bring blame upon the things of God. We won't bring shame. See, that which is lifted up, we are lifted up high. This is why the Bible says we are a city set on a hill. See, a hill is not where the mud is. It is not where the slush of the earthquake is. But a hill is high. It is high for those things that are lowly. Those things that are creeping and crawling cannot get up on a hill. Why? The angels are lifting, are holding us up in this power. The wind of God, the rule of God, the spirit of God, the exousia of God is holding you up in holiness. It's holding you up in righteousness. It is holding you up so there will not be no blame that is brought to the things of God. Did you know that Hagar was in the household of faith? She was in Abraham's tent. She was under his covering. She was one of his servants. So truly God had a accountability. He had a responsibility to take care of Hagar. And so he called her, oh, woman of God, woman of the prodigal, come back home. Return unto your servant. Return unto your home and do what she said do. And then he began to say, oh, I will bless you. I will bless your children. I will bless your son, Lord of God.
Jesus.
Tell me, I got to follow what God say. And I got to listen to this. Listen to this benefit of angels on the side. I got to listen to what the angels say.
Jesus.
And I got to obey what they tell me to do. Because it is God speaking in them, through them. And so the angels, it says, we are safe from every trap. Say with me, I'm saved from every trap. I don't care what witch. I don't care what manipulation. I don't care what demon. I don't care what hater I got. I don't care how bad they want to see me fail. I don't care. I don't care. Every trap. Say with me, he delivered me because I'm under the cover from every trap. Every death and disease. When God say don't touch that. When God tell me to be holy. Say with me, I remain in a holy place. He delivers us from the terrors of the night. Arrows that try hit us in the day. Folks try to throw a ringer in there. They want to see you act out of the character of God. They say stuff to you. People use witchcraft. I'm going to manipulate them. I'm going to let them know that I ain't their friend no more. I'm going to manipulate them. I ain't going to say amen. I ain't going to even encourage them. I ain't got nothing for them. And watch how they carry on. No, baby, those are the people you're supposed to love even harder. Glory to God. Even the Spirit of God will raise up in you and cause you to love them beyond your own means. To you yourself and say, how can I love somebody like that? I know they lied on me. I know they slept with my husband. I know they slept with my fiance. I know they slept with my wife. I know they did what they did to my family. I know they stole my stuff. Glory to God. But I love them. And I hope the best for them.
God. That's the power,
God. This is the power of the angels holding us up, glory to God. Nothing during the day. The Bible says 1,000 shall fall at your head. 10,000 shall fall around you. The Bible says, say, none shall come nigh me. None shall come nigh me. Lack shall not come nigh me. Sickness shall not come nigh me. Cancer shall not come nigh me.
Hallelujah.
You got to rise up and say, I refuse to die with a disease.
Come on.
I refuse to die with cancer. I refuse. You got to get mad. And see, when you honor the Lord honors you. Glory to God. Start setting your heart, your expectation in God. What would God, if God give you what you want, if money was not a factor, why would that God would have the angels to bring you anything? Put it this way. Why would the angel, God have an angel bring you any more than enough? Do you have plans for more than enough? They're holding you up for something. They're lifting you up for people to glorify you. No, to glorify God. You are the light. You are the city that's set on him. God said they're holding you up so you can what? Resembles him. So he can get all the glory and all the honor. People come to the light. People are drawn to the light. People are drawn to that which is good. That which is perfect. Unless they are Judas. But God said, I draw my people through the light that is in you. If my light and if I'm calling you, they will connect with you. If they run from Jesus, who could save them?
Come on.
How could they be saved? Say with me, if I run from Jesus.
If I run from
Jesus. If I run from Jesus. The only one who could save me. Who died for me. How could I be saved? So sometimes people run from that connection, that networking God has for them. You got to know that I got to run into the secret place. I got to run into the shelter where God will cause me to be protected. And it is what? In the house of the Lord. The Bible says they that are planted in the house of the Lord are flourishing in the courts of our God. You're in the house of the Lord outside the four walls of this building. It means that I am connected to the church. I have people praying for me. I have leadership. I have ministers of the gospel praying for me. Yeah. People that are hoping the best for me. If you're out there on your own, you're in trouble.
That's
right. Say with me. Say if you don't need the church, if you want them. Say with me, I do need the church. I need you. 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 You need me. We're all God's family. We're connected. We are the body of Christ. Bible say these wicked devices, glory to God, can't touch us. We don't even have to retaliate against our enemies.
Right.
You don't have to fight just like he told Jehoshaphat. You stand still and see the salvation. You watch me move. Meaning don't hate them. Standing still, not when God tells you to stand still, he's mean, stop hating. Put down the sword, Peter. Stop retaliating. I'm going to do them up. You wait. I see what they did to me. God says, stand still. Let it go. Let it go and let God. Let my power, let my love abide in you. I'm going to work this out for you if you stand still. If you let me work this, you will see the benefit of you going through this. Yea, do I walk what? Through the valley of shadow of death. I will fear what? No evil. Declare with your mouth, the Lord is with me. 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 Everywhere I go. Everywhere I be. I'm under his shelter. I'm under his shadow. That you personally, I'm going to stretch you a little bit this morning on Father's Day. There is a condition, because this is a word from your father to you. And he's saying to you, there is a condition that you personally need to meet. You can't allow error to tell you that grace got me covered.
Oh, my God.
The Bible says he resists the proud, but he gives his grace to those that will what? Humble themselves. He resists those who in their self, you stay in sin. See, proud people don't know what it means to humble themselves to the grace of God. The grace of God is the power of God. It is the favor of God. It is the holiness of God. It is the power of God unto salvation. This is what the grace of God is. It is the fruit of the Spirit. It is the love of God. It is the character of God. It is self-control. It is temperate. It is patient. It is kindness. It is meekness.
You are God of provision. You are God of truth.
healing. You're a God that loves us. You're a God of a second chance. You're a God of a third chance. You're a God of a 70 times 7 chance. You give us another chance, God. Your mercy, oh God. Your grace abound, oh God. Even where sin abound, we thank you that your grace, oh God, is much more abound, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that knowledge and understanding, oh God, wisdom that brings us into truth. Therefore, we refuse, oh God, to reject your word, oh God. We take this word, oh God, we choose to hide it in our heart, that we might not sin against you. We refuse to take an occasion for flesh, sin, or the world, or the devil, but we take this word, and we declare, Lord, that we belong to you, God. We belong to you in the city. We belong to you in the marketplace. We belong to you everywhere we go, God. In the darkness, oh God, where people are not looking, oh God, we belong to you, and we refuse to walk any other kind of way, God, except for saints of the Most High God. We release this over your church, oh God. We release this over the body of Christ. We release a spirit, oh God, that will cause your people to be captivated, oh God, with the passion of the Lord, working as ministers of the gospel, oh God. Your flames of fire, oh God, in the humankind, oh God, moving like your servants in the earth, oh God, and co-laboring with the angels, oh God. We honor you, Lord. 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 We partner with you, Lord. We're co-laborers with Christ, oh God. Hallelujah, Lord. We thank you that you paid it all. Oh, Father. But we, oh God, insist on doing our part, oh God. We don't resist our part. We insist on doing it right, Lord. We're going to do it, oh God. We're going to do our part, Lord. We're going to follow your instruction, oh God. We're going to hear the voice of your spirit, oh God, speaking to us, oh God, giving us direction, oh God, protecting us, oh God. Thank you for your secret place, oh God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. How many feel his protection? Do you feel him protecting you? Come on, the anointing is thick in this place. Come on and reach up, oh God. Oh, Father, pull down the Spirit of God upon your situation. You know what you're going through. You got to pull down the anointing upon your own head. You got to talk to your Abba, Father. He is your daddy, God. Oh, hallelujah. He is the Father of the fatherless. Glory to God. He is the Father of the fathers. Hallelujah. Only he got what you need. Hallelujah. He takes care of his children well. Hallelujah. He is a God. Hallelujah. And his manifold way of doing, oh God, is a foolproof, oh God. His provision is foolproof, oh God. We thank you for your foolproof provision. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, come on and give him praise. Hallelujah. Pull on the oil. Hallelujah. Pull on the oil. Hallelujah. Pull it upon your head, oh God. Pull on your deliverance, oh God. Hallelujah, Jesus. You got to cry out to God, oh God. You know what I need, God. Father, I ask that you forgive me. Father, I've sinned before you, God. I choose to turn, oh God. I choose to turn from everything, every enemy that so easily beset me. I turn from what I want myself, oh God. I turn to what you want, God. It's all about you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. It's all about what you want, God. Hallelujah. I want what you want for me, God. Not my will, Lord. Not my will, but your will be done. Hallelujah. We thank you for your will being done, oh God, in the presence of fire of your angels, moving on our behalf, protecting us, oh God, leading us, oh God, into your righteous indignation, oh God, moving us into your righteous cause, oh God, moving us to be the fruit of righteousness, oh God. Your angels are moving us into winning and the lost, oh God. Your angels are moving us, oh God, to fulfilling, oh God, your divine plan in the earth, oh God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, come on and give him glory. Hallelujah. Somebody need a breakthrough. Hallelujah. And somebody need a breakthrough. Hallelujah. You got to shake yourself, Lord God. You got to break out of those old clothes. Hallelujah. That the word was talking about. Break out of that mold of doing it. And do something different. God say, I dare you to allow your faith to come up. I dare you to want something different. I dare you to ask for something different. I dare you to do something different. And so you got to know that you are a servant of God that got everything. And there's nothing too hard for him. Sarah laughed at the angel when the angel said, you shall bring forth, O mother of all nations. You shall produce, hallelujah. There's a nation in your belly. There's a nation in your belly. There's a nation in your belly. God said, I'm watching your words, daughter. And I'm honoring your words, hallelujah. My angels will carry your word. My angels will carry your word into the uttermost part of the earth. Will you pray for those that are in the cave? Those children, hallelujah, that's in despair. Those children, those orphanages that are bruised and broken. Will you pray, hallelujah? Angels are carrying your words and your prayers, hallelujah, is being heard, oh God. God say, I'm pleased with you. I am pleased with your work. Your labor in me, I hear God, is not in vain, hallelujah. I'm pleased more than you know. I'm going to show you how pleased I am. God say, I'm going to show you, daughter, just how pleased I am with you. Eyes have not heard, ears have not seen, your ears, your eyes, what I got in store for you in this life, said God. God say, not in the Bible, not in the Bible. God say, in this life. He say, in this life, you shall see. You shall see. Glory to God. God say, sweatless labor, sweatless work, glory. Sweatless, he said.